What's up? It's Cort. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have a huge haul video for you. I've got books, I've got plants, I've got books and plants. The best things in life. I also picked up the outfit that I'm wearing today, which is like an athleisure type look from Target. I'll step back so you guys can see the whole outfit real quick. Yeah, it looks like this. I think it's super cute. If you know me, I am not a pink person. I really despise pink. but the black and the blue version, they did not have in my size. So I made do. But it is so cute and comfy. Like, how I couldn't pass it up. I couldn't pass it up. So yes, if you're interested in this cute athleisure look, it is at Target. Also, I do want to note that I have been sick for the past week and I'm still sick. So if you hear a little bit of weirdness in my voice or I get out of breath, that is why. So let's jump on into the plants and books. I think we'll start off with books because that's what most of you guys are here for on my channel. I've got Barnes & Noble, Books A Million, Target, and Book of the Month. So I've got four different places that I've got books from. Let's jump into it. Starting off with books that I got from Barnes & Noble, I went a little deep. I don't know why, I was just seeing these books kind of float around, and I've been reading a lot of fun books lately, or like horror books lately, just enjoyable books, and I thought that I needed to get like a heartfelt book, or like a meaningful book, or something that would just leave me with a feeling. So I picked up two books actually from Barnes & Noble that I think will do the job. So the first one is A Little Life by Hanya Yanagiara. I'm not sure if I pronounced that right, but it looks like this. It is a chunky read. I'll go ahead and read the synopsis real quick so you can get an idea of what it's about. A Little Life follows four college classmates broke, adrift, and buoying only on their friendships and ambition. As they move to New York in search of fame and fortune, while their relationships, which are tinged by addiction, success, and pride, deepen over the decades, the men are held together by their devotion to the brilliant, enigmatic Jude, a man scarred by an unspeakable childhood trauma. A hymn to the brotherly bond and a masterful depiction of love in the 21st century. Hanya Yagahara's stunning novel is about the family we are born into and those that make it for ourselves. So yes, again, I've heard a lot of like really good things about this book. It's emotional, it's a deep read. So I'm very excited to get into this book and I think I'm probably going to do a reading vlog. I might do a reading vlog on this, we'll see. The next book I picked up from Barnes & Noble is another darker read. This is called My Dark Vanessa by Kate Elizabeth Russell. Again, I've heard a lot of really good things about this book, but it is a dark and just, I wouldn't say confusing, but just like, I don't know how to explain it. I'll read the back to you so you can get an idea of what it's about. 2000. Bright, ambitious, and yearning for adulthood, 15-year-old Vanessa Y becomes entangled in an affair with Jacob Strand, her magnetic and gullible 42-year-old English teacher. 2017. Amid the rise of allegations against powerful men, a reckoning is coming due. Strain has been accused of sexual abuse by a former student who reaches out to Vanessa, and now Vanessa suddenly finds herself facing an impossible choice. Remain silent, firm in the belief that her teenage self willingly engaged in this relationship, or redefine herself in the events of her past. Alternating between Vanessa's present and her past, My Dark Vanessa juxtaposes memory and trauma with the breathless excitement of a teenage girl. Thought-provoking and impossible to put down, this is an era-defining novel that brilliantly captures and reflects the shifting cultural mores transforming our relationships and society itself. So yes, this is a teacher and student relationship book where she goes back and forth in time. And again, I feel like this is really going to be triggering for some, so just please be careful and read the warnings before going into it. I don't know if it's going to be too much for me, honestly, so we'll see. But I did want to try to give it a go because it sounds really, really good. Last up from Barnes & Noble, I picked up a book that I've had on my wish list, and it is an exciting book. It is a Grady Hendrix book. It would not be a Cort book haul book video without a Grady Hendrix book, and this one just screams me. It's called We Sold Our Souls by Grady Hendrix. So let me read the back to you and you'll see why I'm so excited about this book. Every morning, Chris Polanski wakes up in hell. In the 1990s, she was lead guitarist of Dirk Work, a heavy metal band on the brink of breakout success, until lead singer Terry Hunt embarked on a solo career and rocketed to stardom, leaving his bandmates to rot in obscurity. Now, Chris works as a night manager of a Best Western. She's tired, broke, and unhappy. Then one day, everything changes. A shock act of violence turns her life upside down, and she begins to suspect that Terry sabotaged more than just the band. Chris hits the road hoping to reunite Dirk Work and confront the man who ruined her life. Her journey will take her from Pennsylvania Rust Belt to a celebrity rehab center to a satanic metal festival, a furious power ballad about never giving up. We sold our souls in an epic journey into the heart of a conspiracy-crazed, pill-popping, paranoid country that seems to have lost its very soul. I'm so excited for this book. It sounds like Warped Tour, heavy metal. I'm just pumped. And it's by Grady Hendrix. Like, it's gonna be so, so good. I picked up one book from Target, and it is another Grady Hendrix book. This is My Best Friend's Exorcism. I've been wanting this book for a while, but I feel like it's never really too hard to find, so I just haven't picked it up. But I saw it was 20% off at Target, so I did. And this one is also a movie. Excuse me real quick. Sorry. This one is also a movie, so I want to do a video about reading this and then watching the movie, because surprisingly, I have not watched this movie. So I'm very excited to read this, and I'll read the back real quick. High school sophomores Abby and Gretchen have been best friends since fourth grade, but after an evening of skinny dipping goes disastrously wrong, Gretchen begins to act different. She's moody, she's irritable, and bizarre incidents keep happening whenever she's nearby. Abby's investigation leads her to some startling discoveries, and by the time the story reaches its terrifying conclusion, the fate of Abby and Gretchen will be determined by a single question. Is their friendship powerful enough to beat the devil? What? I'm so excited. Also, this cover, I love it. It looks like so old school retro. It's very cool. I love it. Moving on to books a million. I got four books and a bookmark. So let me talk about this bookmark real quick. This is the Punk Rock Authors bookmark. I'm trying to get rid of the glare. And it is all of the famous authors gone punk rock. Name something better. Name something better. I'll wait. I think this is so cool. On to books, I picked up this book, which was in the bargain bin for $6.97. This is called Ghost Walls by Sarah Moss. And again, the cover just captured me so well. It looks like butterflies and grass and plants that make a skull. It's so cool. So let me read the inside real quick for you. In the north of England, far from the intrusions of cities but not far from civilization, Sylvie and her family are living as if they were ancient Britons, surviving by tools and knowledge of the Iron Age. For 2 weeks, the length of her father's vacation, they join an anthropology class set to reenact life in simpler times. They are surrounded by forests of birch and rowan. They make stew from forage roots and hunted rabbits. The students are fulfilling their coursework. Sylvie's father is fulfilling his lifelong obsession. He has raised her on stories of the early people, taking her to witness rare artifacts, recounted time and again the rituals and belief, particularly their sacrifices to the bog. Mixing with the students, Sylvie begins to see, hear, and imagine another kind of life, one that might include going to university, traveling beyond England, choosing her own clothes and food, speaking her mind. The ancient build ghost walls to ward off enemies, invaders, rude barricades of stakes topped with ancestral skulls. When the group builds one of their own, they find a spiritual connection to the past. What comes next? How far will they go to conjure the exclusive history? I don't know. It sounds very good, and it looks like a pretty short read, so excited to dive into this one. Next up, I picked Neil Gaiman's Coraline up, and I love Coraline. I love Tim Burton. I love eerie, creepy. You guys know this by now. And I honestly have never read a Neil Gaiman book, and I've been wanting to read one so badly. And I saw Coraline, and I was like, it's perfect. So if you don't know the story behind Coraline, I will read the back to you. But if you've watched the movie, you know the story behind Coraline, and I adore it so much so. While exploring her new home, a young girl named Coraline unlocks a door to reveal a hidden passage. Intrigued, she ventures deep into a mysterious mirror realm, a world eerily similar yet darkly different from her own. Before long, the mysterious turns sinister, and Coraline must use her wits and courage to save herself and the other trapped souls she finds along the way. I love this movie so much, so just having the book in my hands makes me very excited. There's also illustrations in this book that makes me very, very excited. I don't know, it just adds to my excitement for this book. So cute. I just had a coughing attack, so if you can see the red on my nose and my eyes are watering, that's why. I'm trying to stick it out through this video, guys, so bear with me. Next, I picked up Bunny, which has been on my list for a hot minute as well. I just hadn't seen it anywhere, and it was at Books A Million. So I picked it up. I'll read the back. Let me tell you what it's about. A scholarship student who prefers the company of her dark imagination to that of most people, Samantha Heather Mackey, is utterly repelled by the rest of her graduation fiction writing cohort at New England University, a clique of unbearable yet sinister rich girls who call each other Bunny and seem to move and speak as one. But everything changes when Samantha receives an invitation to the Bunny's fable smut salon and finds herself inexplicably drawn to their front door, ditching her only friend Ava in the process. As Samantha plunges deeper and deeper into Bunny's world and begins to take part in their monstrous experiments, the edge of reality begins to blur. Soon her friendship with Ava and the Bunnies will be brought into deadly collision. It just sounds good, and I've heard so many good things about this. The last book that I picked up from Books A Million is this stunning, absolutely stunning, and it just, I can't. Like this, like the watercolor detail, it is so cool. I absolutely love it. This is one of those books that I picked up solely because of the cover, and I knew that I needed to have it. I'm very excited to dive into it. I've heard this one's a good one, so we will see. Hopefully it's good. Lastly, I have two more books to talk about before we dive into the plants, and they are my book of the month book choices. I've got Emily Ratajkowski's My Body. It goes into her sexuality, her experience with modeling and acting at a young age, and I've started it already, as you can see, and it's pretty good, and it brings to light a lot of things that people don't consider, so I'm really excited to dive into this and like finish it. And then I also ordered Sally Hepsworth, The Soulmate, and this book follows a family who moves into a house on a cliff, and the cliff is where a lot of people will go to try to commit suicide, and one day somebody actually does. The husband has been able to save everybody, and then one day a woman does commit suicide and he's not able to save her, and it turns out that he actually knew her. So there's a lot of things that go into this book that I'm excited to read about and see how the plot thickens. All right, so those are all the books that I hauled this weekend, but I also, like I said, hauled some plants. Saturday is just the day for shenanigans with my cousin Maitland. We just go on a rampage, bop around town, and have a good time, and it always involves books and plants, and usually food, sometimes thrifting. Anyways, I've got violets, I've got succulents, and I've got some really cool hanging plants to share with you, so let's jump into it. So the first violet I have is this one. It's called a Rockin' Robin, and it has a really pretty dark reddish pink bud with a white outline. I love it. I think it's so pretty. I also picked up one more pinkish violet. This is the RM Vesna, and it's got like a ruffle bud to it. It's pink and white, and it's so pretty. I don't know. I haven't decided yet if the ruffled violets are my favorite or if the like other ones are, but this is one of the ones that I picked up. The next violet I picked up is Cajun's Christie. This one's really got a cool bud to it. It reminds me of an orchid almost, but it's like this bluish purple with white and yellow, and I don't know, it's super, super unique, so I love this one. Then I picked up Ocean's Surf. This violet I looked at last time I was at Hyams, but it wasn't blooming, so I didn't know what it looks like. But it's got these really pretty, ruffly, dark purple flowers, and I don't know, I think it's gorgeous. It does look kind of like a wave, and it's just pretty. And then the last violet I got is called an RS Ariel, and again, it goes with that purplish bluish look, but it's got kind of like a tie-dye white kind of look to it, so super, super pretty and different. Then I got three succulents that I actually already planted. These are Mimi Cry plants. And they are so pretty. I don't know if you can see them. Okay, yeah, so these ones, and then I have a Living Stone. They're like purpley, I don't know. They're so cool. So I'm very excited, like pink, purple, and then like a little Living Stone. Aren't they cool? I love them. Also, this planter I got at Lowe's, and I think it's really, really cool. Lastly, I have some big plants that I hauled this week. The first one being a fern, and I have very bad luck with ferns. I had another coughing attack, I'm so sorry. The first big hanging plant that I got is a cotton candy fern, and I don't have the best luck with ferns, but this one is so whimsical and magical and just like fluffy and full. I couldn't pass it up. So I'm hoping that I can keep it alive. We will see, but it is just stunning. I am like obsessed with it. I love it. It just looks like magic. It looks like magic. And then the find of the day was this Hoya rope. A Hoya rope. We found it at Lowe's. A Hoya rope. And it's gorgeous. It's so full. It's so pretty. I couldn't believe I found this. I think it was like $19. Yeah, $19.98. People sell like a little baby one of these in specialty shops for 20 bucks. Like this is, I was so excited. So excited. All right guys, I know the haul was long, but I had so many things to catch up because I've been sick and I've just wanted to share all of these in like short videos, but I figured I would just combine them for you guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, let me know if you guys have any books that you're reading or any plants that you've come across lately that I should keep an eye out for. Let me know in the comments down below and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye guys.